The world is billions of years old. Scientists haven't just guessed the number. They've estimated it to a range of plus or minus 50 million years. Let's dive into the fascinating world of geochronology. Wake up! It'll be quick, and by the end of this video, you'll have learned something that most people don't know. Now, if you Google the age of the Earth, you'll get an answer of around 4.5 billion years. But hang on, if you asked someone from the Midwest who's a bit more on the religious side, they might tell you it's without a doubt somewhere between 6 and 10,000 years old. That's quite a range, right? So, everyone agrees it falls between 6,000 and 5 billion years old, which is like saying my bank account has somewhere between $300 and $250 million. So how did scientists land on that 4.5 billion year mark? Let's talk about the scientific dating. No, it's not that kind. We're talking about radiometric dating, a technique that relies on the decay of radioactive isotopes in rocks. Uranium turns into lead at a known rate, allowing scientists to measure the uranium to lead ratio in rock samples. Are you still awake? Great! By analyzing these ratios, scientists can calculate the time it took for uranium to transform into lead. It's a scientific and mathematical process that has time and again proven to be accurate. But wait, there's more. Scientists also use index fossils and stratigraphy. Index fossils, tied to specific time periods, help date rocks. When combined with the study of rock layers, a timeline of Earth's history emerges. Younger rocks generally sit above older ones, helping to solve the geological puzzle. Now, let's throw in the luminescence dating, handy if you want to date sediments and artifacts. See, minerals trap electrons when exposed to sunlight or heat, and measuring the release of these electrons helps estimate how long it's been since exposure. And last but not least, varve chronology. In certain environments, like glacial lakes, sediment layers accumulate seasonally in what's called varves. Counting these varves allows scientists to estimate the age of rocks and events year by year. Mind-blowing, right? So, what would scientists say to someone who claims the Earth is only a few thousand years old?
I'm afraid you're mistaken, sir.
Now, what about those who believe the Earth is less than 10,000 years old? Well, it's around 35 to 40% of the population, and their beliefs often stem from biblical interpretation. Science doesn't aim to disprove religious texts, but there's a sharp difference between church teachings and scientific evidence regarding Earth's age. So what's the verdict? Fortunately, scientists and the religious usually don't engage in debates with each other. Each side is convinced, and there's little point in arguing when minds will not be changed on either side, no matter how good an argument is made. In the end, whether you're into scientific data or biblical interpretations, we've taken a fascinating, informative, and thankfully quick journey through time. If you found this video rock solid, give us a thumbs up. Geochronology, or the study of dating rocks, may not be the most interesting thing in the world, but you now know something most people don't, and something that 35 to 40% will never believe.